Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. This is just going to be a short video about the Google Drive Priority and Workspaces ability that was launched back in March 2019, but is a helpful feature for giving teams the ability to manage personal workspaces and also see what's priority on their list. So in order to enable this, you need a Google Workspace account, previously G Suite, and this allows you to see this view. Now the priority appears on the top left-hand page, but if you wanted to, you can actually change this so that it sets as your default page. In order to do that, you can go to Settings and then go down to Suggestions. Now you need to either deselect if you want the priority page to not be your default homepage, but if you want it as your default homepage, then select it in the Suggestions and it'll appear as the thing that you land on when you open your Gmail. Now, one other thing that Google recently added was the ability to convert automatically any Microsoft Word, Microsoft Slides, and Excel files into Google Docs editor format. Now, you can make sure to select that on if you want it to do it automatically here. So as you can see at the top, what Google will do is make suggestions on things that you've recently interacted with you and your team. Now, obviously all of these have only the prompt of open. However, if you were commenting on them or you were changing the sharing ability to them, that means you'll be able to see a different option here, a different call to action. Now, the interesting thing are these things called workspaces. They belong down here and allow you to create small 20 file limit workspaces to work in, so that anything that you're working on actively. So at the moment I'm briefing the editor about some new introduction videos as he starts his first week. So in this case, I might want to start adding some files that are useful to this. So as you can see here, the workspace is open and what you can do is start adding files. Now you don't naturally upload them from your file or computers area, you go to add files. And as you can see on the right hand side, the ability to add to workspace appears. So I might select a few things that we might be working on together and that might need to review on my side. So these might be active documents for you, but you could have this for an upcoming really important presentation or meeting so that you've got all of your files in the right location. So if I press insert, as you can see here, it creates this automatically and I can go and press done here. So if I ever need to come to this quickly, I can quickly access them there. But if I wanted to have multiple ones, I can have as many as I like. So what's cool is you can go to My Drive, you can go to Shared With Me, you can go to different options as well. You can also, for example, have not just meetings set up, but you could also have per department. But in this case, I could have things I need to review. So I may actually want to review a few things in my workspace that I've been working on. So I'm gonna select a few of these files and insert them. And as you can see, you can add different types of formats. But this is helpful to create almost notes or I guess collections of things that you might want to save for later. So for example, if you want to remove it, you can quickly get rid of it. Naturally, the files won't disappear. These are just collections of things that are already in your Google Drive. Almost just like temporary folders, but a little bit more easier to access. But you can also hide a workspace. So for example, when I'm done with this, I could hide the workspace and they will appear down here as almost like an archived section. You can also unhide, which basically restores it to this main area. So if I'm in My Drive and I want to right click on something, I can actually add it to a workspace that exists. For example, if I wanted to move this to things to review or create a new workspace from here, that's how I can do it. And naturally, if I go back to the priority section, you should see that available in here. So that's how the priority and workspaces section work. And as you can see here, this is how teams are using it to be a bit more fluid. As you can see, a better example when it comes to all the different departments and usage for the Google Workspace. So folks, hopefully that was a useful overview of this feature. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. Anyway, folks, a big thank you and cheerio.